Hello and welcome to this new lecture on overhaul, repair, replace. So what we are going to see in this particular lecture, we'll see what do we mean by overhaul, repair and replace. Later on we'll see the advantage of overhaul, repair and replace, and also a formula to calculate the time of overhauling. So let us see one by one these three. So first thing is, what do we mean by maintenance? Maintenance can be defined as it is a daily, weekly inspection as per the schedule to carry out the various activity. What does it mean? It means maintenance is an activity which is already scheduled and one has to execute. It might have the frequency of daily basis execution, it might have the frequency of weekly basis execution, or it might have the frequency of hourly basis execution. So it is pre-planned activity. And few example of maintenance could be the cleaning of the oil cleaning, might be the changing of the filter or filling of gas. All these comes under the category of maintenance, because these has to be performed after certain interval of time. Next is overhauling. What do we mean by overhauling? So overhauling means taking apart every component and inspect. I mean, if I need to overhaul a whole machine, what I have to do? I have to dismantle the whole machine and I have to inspect each and every component of the machine. So what overhauling deals with? Time between overhauls. So how one can calculate the time between overhauling that need to be done at a certain period of time. So if I talk about the overhauling, it is the maintenance or repair of the whole machine. So it is expensive, but it is not limited to the replacement only. If the components can be replaced, if need to be replaced, that can be replaced. Otherwise, what we will do, we will repair that the component. Next is repair. So repair is performed, you can see over here, activities carried out on any machine when defect problem has been reported or observed. When repair has to be performed, it has to be performed when the defect has occurred. I mean, maintenance is something which has to be done before the occurrence of the activities, and repair is something which is done after the occurrence of the activity. I mean, it is done after the failure has occurred. And repair is obviously unscheduled activity. It is done as and when required. I mean, as and when the failure happens, the repair has to be done. So let us see few more things. Overhauling, how we can define the overhauling? Overhauling can be defined as the process of general maintenance performed on a machine or other industrial equipment. So what does this mean? Overhauling is something which is general maintenance. I mean, maintenance of the whole machine or whole industrial equipment. Goal of overhauling is to keep the system in serviceable condition. What do we mean by serviceable condition? We do mean that the equipment must be in a condition, good enough condition, that it can provide the intended services or the services which it has to perform. Next thing is, overhaul is usually performed by the company offering the maintenance services. I mean, if you can see, there are so many companies which manufacture the air conditioning system, but they do outsource somebody else, third party, to get perform their servicing and overhauling of the air conditioning system. So overhaul is done by the third party. I mean, the company, you can see over here, overhaul is usually performed by the company offering the maintenance services. Next thing is we will look into the benefits of overhauling exclusively. So what are the benefits of overhauling? So if I talk about replacing a part is more cost effective than buying a new machinery. Okay, so if in overhauling we might need to replace a particular default faulty components. So if you could replace that faulty component, then the machine will work as a new machine. So we need not to purchase a new machine if any machine is dysfunctional or faulty. So it is more cost effective. एंड सेकेंड पॉइंट इज हाउ इट इज़ मोर कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव. सडन ब्रेक डाउन विल कॉज फाइनेंशियल लॉसेस. वॉट डज इट मीन? सपोज इज वन असेंबली लाइन इज देयर. इफ द वन एनी पर्टिकुलर मशीन्स बिकम फॉल्टी, सो वॉट विल हैपन? द होल लाइन विल आई मीन बिकम अनफंक्शनल. ओके, सो इट विल कॉज द ह्यूज फाइनेंशियल लॉस टू दैट पर्टिकुलर फर्म. सो वॉट वन कैन डू? वन कैन परफॉर्म द रूटीन overhauling, one can perform the routine maintenance, and that will reduce the sudden breakdown, and in turn it will reduce the financial loss that may occur during the sudden breakdown. Next is major industrial company recognize timely repair. Most of the companies do have a maintenance department which do perform the maintenance of the machine on. So and this which component has the more frequency of use, which component has more frequency of the failure. So this is how they perform the maintenance of components and machines. Next benefit of overhauling is it allow the potential issues to it certainly it will overhauling will increase the lifespan of that particular machine or that particular component or that particular system. So how it will enhance or extend the lifeline? It will enhance the life by allowing the potential issues to be fixed even before the failure occurs. So it will reduce the chances of the failure, because one is already tracing the things that are happening in that machine. Due to wear, certainly if the machine is running and machine component due to friction and a few other things, the wear will happen, and due to wear the breakdown may occur. So if we are performing the overhauling, we are aware about the wear and we can replace that particular component before the actual breakdown takes place. Next thing is overhauling stop the extensive damage of the machinery and increase the length of its life cycle. So it will stop the damage in the machinery just because of the faulty components, and this is how it will increase the length of the length or life cycle of that particular machine. Next is increased performance. So you can see how it can increase the performance, over how overhauling can increase the performance. Machine performance can be restored up to 100%. I mean that the faulty machine, if overhauling is performed in the rightest manner, then that particular machine can be restored up to 100% that 100% functionality. So 100% functionality means that it can perform it as a brand new machine which has already used. Increased performance of the machine represents the possibility to increase the level of production. Obviously, if we are comparing between two machines, one which is new machine and other which is old machine, so certainly the new machines will have the more productivity. Okay, so we are performing the overhauling on certain interval of time, then that machine can work as a new machine. So if it is working as a new machine, then the productivity of machine will increase. Reduce labor cost. So how overhauling can reduce labor cost? Suppose the failure of machine occurs, then what will happen? We need to do the replacement, and for the replacement some time period is required. I mean, if one component has to be replaced, then first what one need to do, one need to procure that particular component from the market, and from market one has to fetch it to the factory or the organization, and later it will be replaced. So what will happen during this period of time? The labor who is performing the function on that particular machine will remain the idle. So if the labor will remain idle, then there will be a labor cost associated with the labor. So next thing is predictive maintenance reduces the number of critical call outs and naturally the amount of time spent on service call. So what are the stages of overhauling? Till now we have seen the benefits of overhauling. What are the benefits? So we have seen it is cost effective, it increases the lifespan of machine, and so having seen the benefits of the overhauling, now we will see what are the stages that are associated with the overhauling, how the overhauling is actually performed. So first stage in the overhauling is inspection. Suppose we are having 10 machines, so the expert who is expert in the overhauling will inspect all those machines, and he or she will identify the machine on which the overhauling has to be performed. So if when the machine is identified, then what will be done, the whole machine will be disassembled. I mean, it will all the components which were there, that will be disassembled, and each component will be inspected. Each component will be inspected, and it will be seen whether the component is working properly or not. If one find that component is not working properly, then we do the replacement of it, or we may do the repair of it. After disassembly, we can either repair the component or replace the component. After repairing and replacing the component of that machine, what we will do in the next stage, we will reassemble all the components, and after reassembling the component, that particular machine will be tested, and after the testing, it will be in the use again. So this is a typical mathematical model to calculate the cycle time in the overhauling. So how one can calculate the cycle time? So you can see there are some formulas: overhaul and cycle time. So how one can calculate the overhaul timing? It can be calculated by the formula given over here: ETOB equals TOR T0 plus 0 to integration 0 to T0 TFT equals 0 to T0 RT DT. So this, what does these notations mean? RT means system reliability, FT means failure density function, T0 mean time to next overhaul. So mean time to next overhaul means the time period over which the overhauling has to be performed. Suppose for an engine that the time period might be 1000 hours. So it is time, mean time between two overhaul. Next is TOB, time between actual overhaul. Mean time is basically a scheduled time at which overhaul has to be performed, and TOB is the actual time when we are performing the overhaul. So how one can calculate the overhaul time? It is ETOB equals 0 to T0 e to the power minus delta t equals 1 upon lambda minus 1 upon lambda bracket 1 minus e to the power minus lambda T0 back. So what does lambda means? Lambda means a failure rate. So we can understand it by an example. An aircraft engine is scheduled for a complete overhaul every 10,000 hours, flying or failure requiring removal of the engine. What does this means? इसका मतलब ये है कि जो इंजन है आपका, उसका ओवरहॉल पर 10,000 आवर्स में होना चाहिए, या तो हर 10,000 घंटे पे होना चाहिए, या फिर उसका एक्चुअल फेलर होता है तब उसका ओवरहॉल होना चाहिए. अज्यूमिंग दैट द फेलोर रेट, इसमें फेलोर रेट दे रखा 10^-5 फेलोर पर फ्लाइंग आवर्स फॉर इंजन. सो लैम्डा की वैल्यू हो गई इसमें 10^-5, और ये आपका जो T0 दिया है, मीन टाइम बिटवीन ओवरऑल, ये कितना आपको दिया है? 10,000 आवर्स. तो यहाँ पे हमको ETOB कैलकुलेट करना है, टाइम बिटवीन ओवरऑल. सो आप देख सकते हैं टाइम बिटवीन ओवरऑल, ये वाले फार्मूला में वैल्यू पुटअप करेंगे हम इस वाले फार्मूला, तो 1/λ, तो 1/λ हो जाएगा 1/10^-5, तो 1/10^-5 का मतलब 10^5, और 1 e^(-λ). सो माइनस लैम्डा मीन्स 10^-5 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई T0. T0 इज द मीन टाइम बिटवीन टू ओवरहॉल. सो मीन टाइम बिटवीन टू ओवरहॉल इज 10,000. वील पुट दिस वैल्यू ओवर हियर. यहाँ पे हमने ये वैल्यू पुट अप कर दी. इसके बाद जब आप इसको निकालेंगे तो इसका आ गया 9516 फ्लाइंग आवर्स. तो एक्चुअल जो हम ओवरहॉलिंग करना है वो कब करना है? 9516 फ्लाइंग आवर्स पे करना है. ठीक है. नेक्स्ट इज ओवरऑल हाउ ओवरहॉलिंग इज इम्पोर्टेंट फ्रॉम द रीसेलर्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. तो इसमें हम देख सकते हैं, वन कैन सी टाइमली रिट्रोफिट. रिट्रोफिट मीन्स द अनडिजायरेबल और द फॉल्टी कंपोनेंट्स कैन बी रिप्लेस विद द अदर कंपोनेंट्स सो दैट इट कैन बी यूजफुल फॉर द एंड यूजर्स. मेंटेनेंस इक्विपमेंट्स इंक्रीज द प्रोडक्टिविटी. तो मेंटेनेंस इफ द वी कीप ऑन परफॉर्मिंग द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ एन इक्विपमेंट देन इट विल enhance the productivity and in and also the life cycle of that particular machine. Overhaul can increase the reseller profit from a used machinery. So if the machine is in good, if we are performing the overhauling on the regular interval of time, then the machine's productivity and will be good. So the reseller can be purchased sale. It can be sale at a good price to the other fellow. Investing some machine in money into repair maintenance is just a stretch then compared to the returns. So if we are investing some money in the repair maintenance, it is just a small money, and what we can get in return will be a huge amount of money.